blessings and the promises, Bishop. God, everything that God has elect. Look, there are some things that God do without your intervention. Let's take, for example, love does not have to pray for the sun to rise up in the morning. Whether love pray or not, whether Pastor Jehudi she fast or not, the sun will still rise and the sun will still go down. Yeah. These are blessings that are permanently in our life. But there are other kinds of blessings. There are things you have to do before you can get those blessings.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Psalm 81 verse 10, Psalm 81 verse 10, he said, I am the Lord our God. We brought thee out of Egypt. Open your mouth wide. And I, God, I will fill it.
Amen.
So it seems to me that if your mouth will be filled, you have the responsibility to what? Open your mouth for it to happen. Too many of us, we think that certain blessings are just automatic. Once I'm in Champion's Temple, all the things that will just happen, by the time I appear the job, if your man go to volunteer, they'll give me promotion. It don't work like that. If you get a promotion, you got to do the work. So that they can feel, the favor of God can be activated in the things you are doing.
Amen.
So the choices we are making, Jacob chose that, okay, I will not let this particular injury go until I get the blessing I need in life.
Amen.
I don't know about you, if your life is okay the way you are living, being scared in the 24/7, you can't even go to the park, that your situation is okay. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
If that's your life, that's it. I mean, I'm not even condemning that. And now you say, all of us not want to sing though. There are some people, they got a grace though. Like God, some people when they're singing, thousands of people can fall. Do you know there are some other men of God when they write a prayer, they get to your hand, like 100,000 people that, when I do my hand, nothing happened. You say, I know my life, I want to say, yeah, working towards going there, praise the Lord.
Amen.
So all of that level in life. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Get back on track. God's election, God's desire to be a blessing to you does not supersede your effort to receive that blessing.
Man.
So, if the Bible says God will protect you if you put your trust in Him, then even though God wants to protect you now, with all you putting your trust in, there's no way for God to do it. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
There are many, many blessings of God that are like that. That's why we need to discover in this month of having power with God and power with men, we need to discover the things we need to do so that we can activate, we can unfold, we can open the heavens. Bishop, we're talking about something. Bishop, we're talking about the widow. That, let me tell you, in fact, I discover, as Bishop, we're talking, men of God, as you are talking about receiving revelation, all the people we are celebrating today in the Bible, all of them acted on some word of God. They all did something so that their names can be mentioned in the Bible.
Amen.
The woman said within her heart, she said, if I can touch the hem of his garment, I know that I will be made whole. The Bible says she reached out into the crowd and she's, that is against all the tradition. Do you know the way she was feeling? She's not even so be among people. That they have someone, you know, the way you're looking at, you even so counsel, right?
Yeah.
But she said within her heart that if I can touch the hem of his garment, I know that will be made whole.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And we saw her being made whole. Daniel, he said what? When he said, they turned the bow down to the image. If you bow down to the image, you'll be dead. Daniel, when he did not bow down to the image, he said what? The king was asking, Daniel, did the God you are serving save you? He said, yeah, my God has said and shut the mouth of the lions.
Amen.
So that he has not even heard one. Do you know that Daniel had to exercise faith to believe that God is able to protect him in the midst of the lion?
Amen.
The three Hebrew boys, right? They said to him, even if the God we are serving choose not to deliver us, we will still not bow down to that image. Cast us into the fire. We prefer to die than to go against the word of God. They believed God to the extent that they were thrown in the fiery furnace. Then the promises of God's protection was activated because they believed in God and they stood on the word of God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So if it will happen for you in the hour of Corona, you need to believe in the word of God. You need to act on the word of God. Even Pastor Joe Lishi was teaching the other time. He was talking about dealing with challenges. Praise the Lord. He brought the story of David. And I love this story because like, for 40 days and 40 nights, every single morning, David, 1 Samuel chapter 17. Every single morning, Goliath will come and stand in front of the armies of the living God. And he will say, I defy the armies of the living God. Send me somebody here to challenge me and see if I will not kill the person. That is, as a guy was defying the army that will free me. You know what I'm saying? That was, they said Goliath was a man of war. He was the hammering feet. He carried skills and all kinds of. When you see the guy looking fearful. 40 days. The conditions, the conditionality of that challenge remained true and constant for 40 days. Every single day, Goliath will come in front of the children, the armies of the Goliath will uncircumcised, though. Uncircumcised God 40 days challenging army. Nothing changed during the period that Goliath was challenging the army. But one day when David heard about the thing, David started asking questions. He said, so what will happen if somebody killed that guy that challenged the army of the living God? They said the king will reward him. He went to the other place, he asked questions again. What will happen if somebody defeat them? And he said, they will reward you. He went to the other place. So David kept asking questions one day. The question that went before Saul. Saul said for David. Saul looked at David for long. David, the first word I came out of David must say, Lord, nobody will worry, I'll go and kill that guy for you. Then Saul, even the king, the head of the armies of the living God, he looked at Saul for David for long. He said, David, you're not able to go against Goliath. You are just a youth. Goliath has been fighting from the days of his youth.
Yeah.
Don't even bother to do it. You can't make it, you just watch out. So then David understood the principles of God. He understood that uncircumcised Philistine cannot challenge living army of God. Amen. Even though Saul and the rest of the whole army didn't understand it, David understood the principle. Amen. David said, though he has played the Saul, all kind of stuff. Well, that thing will happen if I chase lion, I kill lion, this, that. Said, don't worry, then God will be the same way.
Yep.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So the only thing that was different. For 40 days, the conditionality was a sin. The only thing that was different was that one. David stood up and acted upon the promises of God. If you're going to have power with God, you need to act on the promises of God.
Oh,
has God said that your enemy will be under your feet? Yes, the word of God said your enemy will be under your feet. Has the word of God said that by my God, I can leap through a troop? I can scale a wall. By your God, you can subdue enemies.
Amen.
One scripture said, let the high priest of God be in their mouth and a double-edged sword in their hand to execute vengeance upon coronavirus. That is, when you open your mouth, let the high priest of God be in your mouth. But some people, when they open their mouth now, praise the Lord. The thing I come inside and I do it, that is, Lord have mercy.
Amen.
It's my prayer that the Holy Spirit will speak to us.
Amen.
And the Holy Spirit will educate us. He will empower us this month so that we can be able to stand upon the promises of God to activate the blessings that God has already released upon us.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So, for 40 days and 40 nights, once David stood on the promises, David was like going in front of Goliath. Then Goliath was like, when Goliath saw David coming, Goliath looked at David, he said, when am I a dog or am I a stone that you bring in rock and tinder against me? They see rock and tinder that you are condemning. Then they see rock talking away.
Yeah.
God can use even rock to deal with coronavirus.
Amen.
God can use even the simple things in your house to probe. Look, let me our God is such an awesome God. Look, I just have so much. I'm sorry, please forgive me. I just have so much trust and confidence in the God I'm serving.
Hallelujah.
That I'm not even worried about this whole thing. Look,
amen.
Anything will happen, I happen by the blessing, but I know that my God is able to carry me through.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And so I want to talk about only three things over the next 5 minutes that I want you to start doing, praise the Lord.
Amen.
To activate your power with God. Psalm chapter 40, Isaiah chapter 41, verse 1. Says what? I am the Lord that God which. Let me just read it. So Isaiah chapter 41. These are the three things I want you to leave from here when you go home.
Amen.
I want you to understand that you are not your own person.
Amen.
You belong to God. Amen. You are the son and daughter of the living God.
Amen.
Imagine Donald Trump's son. Yeah, any ordinary people can even talk to him because of his relationship with the president. So you are now sons and daughters of the living God. So the enemy has no power over you because of your relationship with God. Let me Isaiah 43 down there. Isaiah 43 verse 1 says, but now, thus saith the Lord God that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee. For I have redeemed thee. and have called thee by name.
Amen.
Thou art mine. Fear not, Pastor Gerald Ishi, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name.
Amen.
If I knew your crew, knew your anger, and your capricorn here, praise the Lord. Fear not. I know you. I formed you in the belly.
Amen.
You are mine. You are my son. You are my daughter. You are under my protection.
Protection.
When you step out into the waters will not drown you. When you
Hallelujah.
Walk through the fire will not burn you because you are mine.
Amen.
That thing needs to sink into your consciousness daily when you wake up. When you step out in the morning, the first word out of mouth say, Lord, I am yours.
Yes.
I soak myself in the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
I soak my children in the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
I cover my job with the blood of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Because I belong to the living God.
Yes.
Amen.
In your word, when you continue reading Isaiah 43, you say, well, when you walk through the waters, waters will not drown you. When you walk through the fire, fire will not burn you. When you go through corona pandemic, it will not burn you.